Okay, I'm gonna do my own recommendation, which is to go into a custom lobby and practice that timing. So I'm gonna select the Radiant. I'm gonna go localhost because I want to. Cheats are gonna be on because I'm gonna spawn something to suck my XP. And then there's not gonna be any bots. So all I'm gonna do is pick Alch. I will start the game. I'll summon some Chen to sit in my lane and suck XP and be useless. And then I will show you how I think it should be played. Okay, so create hero Chen. Send this boy down here. I'm gonna buy items as if I was playing a real game, even though I don't feel like I need regen. Something like this seems good. In fact, I could probably just make this a... Oh, I don't care. Fairy fire. Not sure what the command to give bots an item is, but we'll just put him here to suck XP because that's really what I care about.
You have your marching orders. Okay.
I'm not even gonna go for bounties. Actually, I can send him for the bounties because he's got two.
Okie dokie.
You can, it's always nice to block a little bit. I actually don't mind if it gets under my tower. It kind of protects me while I use his first lockets. I don't actually mind missing these first few. Obviously, I prefer not to, but my goal is to get the XP as fast as possible. I want to go Soul Ring. Yeah. Even though this isn't completely realistic, there's a lot of value you can get out of this for just like when you have a very easy lane. I need to cut this tree for my support.
Yes.
I wanted that to stack, but it didn't.
Your deal.
Fires pass.
You got it.
I'm reading the damage because I don't need the regen.
That's what I thought.
Important to like just see what can you do when you're alone. So that's really like my thoughts. And I'm not gonna use them anymore. Just save your base. Not soaring because I have plenty of mana and I want the health. It's like, man, but I don't put your mind. I've got Fury now, so I can actually think about putting more points in my E, and I've kind of hit my my power spike, right? Watching bottom lane, even though I'm not there. If it gets closer to the top, then I'll deal with it. I'm gonna cast a spray like this. That way I can pull all of these creeps into it. Bottom is still fine. I should have done the stack.
Okay, okay.
And I'll farm that stack later. We have a swine later on my tower, I'm at TP because I don't see it. Freely, I guess it's important not to miss random lasts, so I'm like, really don't hold back. I kind of want to make this guy block. Guy walk in on the spawn. So I get some extra gold here. I'm feeling safe, and there's a wave. But I'm saying not safe. Siege creep's not worth my time. Smart, I can actually farm this first, and then farm this after he gets his cooldown in 3 seconds. That will spawn to my creeps. I'm gonna drop my battle fear here so I don't cleave. That way I can try to scoop the wound and then the body to proc off of it. I've got travels now. So I'm looking at where's farm, that's easy. TP in 3, so I'll probably just farm this and TP bottom. I'm gonna go bottom. This camp, go to the small camp, and then stack the medium camp. Good. Cut the tree to make it easier. Acid spray. This camp is not convenient, so I can do it. Save ult for their stack is really strong, or oops, I misplaced this. Or for going to the lane, that's why I'm in danger. Mess this up because I'm talking. SNY is on the way. We'll get a blink just to round things out. We've got a stack here that we made ourselves earlier. Always switching the targets to the biggest or the highest HP creep. Yes. If it gets around time, we should be able to stack this once more. Oops.
You
hurt him.
Here, I've got a wave. I'm going to point at this camp because the camp will still be here. It always clips the creep instead of its arm. It's so mean. It's been a bug for a while. I didn't even show you what it's telling.
Gotta get rid of this.